time for the match game, Hollywood Squares. Hour with Gallagher. And our special tribute to Leave It to Beaver. Eddie Haskell and Jerry Mathers as the Beaver, and the star to the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bauman.
How do you do? How do you do? Okay.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you. I guess they're getting ready a little early here, aren't they, for the New Year?
Apparently. This is our very last show before the New Year.
Exactly.
1984. And you know what 1984 marks?
What?
Another year that Leave It to Beaver is going to be on television every day of the week.
On reruns. Right. All right, let's
get it
now.
Since 1957.
Oh, gang. Yay.
Here we go.
Here they are, the Beaver cast and Gallagher. Are you starting the festivities early?
We have our balloons.
Yes, I just feel so festive, I just couldn't wait.
A little hydrogen?
No, this is helium.
Helium.
I had to get off hydrogen, it was making me sick.
you
want a hit?
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Say, gosh, Wally, you talk funny.
Gosh, Wally, you talk funny. That's
oh, yeah,
got it.
That's great. All right, let's greet our two players here, Mark King and Sherry Tash. Okay, let's get acquainted. Mark, tell us about you, please.
I'm a salesman from Ahwatukee, Arizona, and...
Never heard of that place. Ahwatukee?
It's just south of Phoenix.
Okay.
Look, about 7 miles.
All right.
And I'm basically here on a dare from my wife.
You what?
I'm here on a dare from my wife.
No kidding.
Yeah.
She said, I dare you to go to Los Angeles, try and get on a game show.
Yeah.
And you did.
Yeah.
Hmm. Where, is she here?
No, she's home with the baby.
All right. All right, Mark.
Dare you to do that, too?
She dared him, and he did it. Okay, Sherry, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. I'm not here on a dare. I live in Malibu. I have a beautiful 7-year-old daughter named Danielle.
Yeah.
I work as an actress, and I also have my own aerobics business in Malibu.
No kidding.
Yeah.
You must be in great shape.
Well, I try. But I wanted the panel to know that my friends and I used to play Beaver trivia games, and I got stumped on the hairdresser. So I'll never forget Florence Bush was the hairdresser. That
right,
was the one.
Right.
Correct?
Right.
You do remember.
Malibu.
Bush is a good name for a hairdresser.
All right. Good luck to both of you. Let's begin the match game. You'll have 3 chances to match as many of our stars as you can. The one who's done that most often will be the winner. Go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. All right, Mark, you won the toss. You go first. Do you want A or B?
Let's go with A.
All right, we'll go with A. And we will begin. Here we go. The restaurant owner said, I'll never let Fat Freddy have my all-you-can-eat special again. Well, first he ate all my food, then he ate my blank. Okay. I guess already down there. Here we go, Mark. The restaurant owner said, I'll never let Fat Freddy have my all-you-can-eat special again. First he ate all my food, then he ate my blank.
Dishes.
Dishes. All right. That's one possibility. Anything you'd find in a restaurant would be good. Dishes would be one good choice. Silver would be another one, I suppose. Barbara, what'd you say?
It wasn't dishes, sorry. Menu.
He ate the menu.
Oh, I like that.
All right. Gosh, Beaver, look at that guy.
Really?
Well, I figured if it was Fat Freddy, I mean, there'd only be one or two dishes in front of him, but the tables would be real big, so he'd eat all
the tables. All right. So far, we don't have dishes, Ken.
Gosh, Mr. Rayburn, this gentleman is so fine, I really wanted to match him. But I'm afraid I matched Jerry again. Tables.
I said tables. All right. Whoops. Okay, John, you're up.
Yes.
First he ate all my food, then he ate my...
He can take it, but can he dish it out? He can.
Very good. All right, one for Mark. What do you say, Richard Deacon?
I said furniture.
He ate the furniture. He needed the roughage, I suppose.
Yes.
Hey, Gallagher.
What did I say?
Yes.
The cashier.
He ate the cashier. That was pretty smart. Yes. Anything else in your bag of tricks down there?
No.
All right. Okay, now let's go over to Sherry here and see if she can, how she does with her question, the B question. The Mona Lisa is speaking, and she said, I'll tell you why I'm wearing this funny smile. All these years, I've been sitting on a blank.
I have the definitive answer, I believe.
You have the definitive answer. We'll find out in a moment or so. All right, Sherry, we're about ready for you. The Mona Lisa said, I'll tell you why I'm wearing this funny smile. All these years, I've been sitting on a blank.
I don't think I can say what I'm really thinking, so I will go with whoopee cushion.
Whoopee cushion. That's funny. That would make her smile in a bemused way, wouldn't it, Barbara?
Made me smile, but I didn't have it.
What'd you say?
Feather.
Feather is her answer.
Sorry.
All right, Beaver, what do you say?
I thought if she was sitting there and she had to sit on a pin all day, she might have a funny smile.
Yes. Pain. I think that would create more pain than a smile, don't you, Ken?
Well, actually, I was thinking of what she said, and I decided I better not write it either, so I went with tack.
A tack. All right.
A tack. The
little lady
ready to attack, yeah.
Looking for a whoopee cushion.
Well, you know, I'm ashamed of this contestant. I mean, my 3.5-year-old daughter sits on a whoopee cushion and thinks that that's funny, you know, and that's kind of the mentality that's involved in this kind of thing.
Don't get emotional, John.
So I said whoopee cushion.
So far, John, you're the only one who's
taking myself
us
right
going
out of the
here.
Game.
Right. Richard?
I didn't know whether I could say that or not, so I said a soft rubber cushion. Would that
now, wait
be...
a minute.
The rubber
cushion. Happy? Was it happy? Whoopee! They gave it
that's
to
a
him.
Whoopee cushion.
Sure.
Yeah. All right. Well, if you really had it in mind, you should have said a soft rubber cushion that would make a funny sound when you sat on it.
You then, can't buy
they bought it. Yeah.
No, they didn't buy it. Oh, you got a buzz on that and not a gong.
Well, that's very disappointing.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. Thank you.
Boy, Gallagher?
I just got class. Nobody else does, that's all.
Here.
So you think you have class. Did you write down a French word on your card?
I'm not bilingual. I'm just class.
Well, I'm bilingual. I wrote down she was smiling because she sat on the paint palette.
On the paint palette. Okay. So there we have round one. Each of you has matched one of the stars, so the score is 1-1. A tie will go to round two right after this. Two. Now, since the score is tied and he went first last time, Sherry, we'll ask you to go first this time.
I'll take A.
You want A? That's it. You got it. Easy. Dave said, my wife's face could launch 1,000 ships. Unfortunately, her blank could sink them. All right. Okay, Barbara?
Yeah, wait, okay.
All right. Sherry?
Got it.
Dave said my wife's face could launch 1,000 ships. Unfortunately, her blank could sink them.
This time I have a French answer, a tush.
Her tush.
Oh, good French.
She's a little heavy there, was she? She said she was a little heavy in the tush, and therefore that's why she said that, Barbara.
I started to say hips, but I didn't. I said body.
Her body could sink them. All right, Jerry, what have you got?
Well, that was a real toss-up. I said it was probably weight, but I put body.
All right, you have two of those, Ken. Another body for you?
She should have known that Gallagher's the only bilingual one in here.
Body.
No French.
So what you're saying is when we get to Gallagher, he's going to say tush, huh?
Right.
All right, Richard, we're up to you.
I was thinking of... I said buns to begin with, and I changed it to body.
Ah, too bad that would have been a match. Yeah. All right, you're getting close, though, Sherry. Okay, Gallagher.
Do you think I put tush?
Sure.
No, I put breath.
Breath, another good answer. So no match for Sherry. Okay. Mark, here we go with you. I'll tell you why Dumb Donald is in the hospital.
Wonder why.
Would you like to know?
Yes.
Thank you. It happened after he asked Mr. T if the T stood for blank. And that put him in the hospital. Here we go, Richard. Okay. I'll tell you why Dumb Donald is in the hospital, Mark. It happened after he asked Mr. T if the T stood for blank.
Mr. Terrific?
No, now wait a minute. Mark, you're not listening to me. Your wife back in Arizona is going to hit you in the head with a baseball bat. So he's easy. In the hospital, so you see. So those are the operative words. Well, that's the answer we have to go for, your first response. Mr. Terrific, it's not going to match anybody here, and I bet $1,000 on that right now. But we'll canvass you anyway.
I
Barbara?
Think that's a terrific answer.
Tootsie.
Tootsie. Well.
That would definitely put you in the hospital.
I don't think you'd be too thrilled with that. That's a good response. Okay, Beav.
Well, when you said Tootsie, he'd say, I'm pretty tough, and put you in the hospital.
What?
Tough.
Tough. T stood
for tough.
That's good
as terrific.
You know, and he was going to show him how tough he was, put him in the hospital. I tried.
Not very hard.
It's almost as good as terrific.
We're still worried about the Beaver.
Listen, the way they booed Jerry, I'm afraid to bring mine up here. I said trouble.
He stood for trouble. Nobody understands this question, including Mark.
And it's Friday. They don't have another day to learn how to play. Chance.
Right. Richard, do you understand it?
Oh, start with your boo now, okay?
Come on.
Boo.
Teeth.
Yeah. What have you got?
Come on, Gallagher.
Well, I think I understand the question.
You do?
He was insulted because they said the T stood for timid.
Timid. Turkey would have been another good one.
Tooth fairy, I would have.
Tooth fairy, turkey, any of those things would have been good.
Tush!
I hope we're all going to start playing this game soon, are we? You must obey orders. 1-1 to score. Round 3. Last chance here. Come back. Third and final round here. Last chance.
This is it.
Are you ready? Now, remember to think carefully before you respond. Mark, she went first last time. Score still tied. You go first this time.
Let's go with B.
All right. Here's Mark's question. Unlucky Louie said, I followed a rainbow all the way to the end. Just my luck. I wound up with a pot of blank. Ready, Mark? Unlucky Louie said, I followed a rainbow all the way to the end. Just my luck. I wound up with a pot of blank.
Pennies.
Pennies?
Instead of gold, pennies?
Instead of gold, you say pennies. Thought about that real hard, didn't you?
I dare you to change your answer.
Long way back to Awatuki.
You better change it if it's going to match mine.
You'll be visiting your wife soon.
Yes. Maybe she should have dared him to go on The Price is Right.
Unless we end up with a tie here and have to have a dumb-off between the two of them. Okay.
Thanks.
All right, Barbara.
I put manure.
Manure.
Wow.
Manure.
Mom put manure?
Yep, Mom put manure.
I was much closer than that. I figured gold and the alchemist, they always took lead and changed it into gold.
So, out of lead. All right, that's okay. Lead, manure, all right, Ken?
Gee, Mrs. Cleaver, I'm ashamed of you writing something like that. But I said manure, too.
You did. All right. Richard, what have you got?
Whatever she says, I say, manure.
Okay.
That shows a lot of class, Richard. Really.
Well, I think I understood that question. They wanted to know what does lie at the end of the rainbow.
Explain it to me, explain it to them.
Melted crayons.
Melted crayons. A wonderful answer, Gallagher.
I hate it. Not likely to match anyone other than another Gallagher.
Well, Sherry, here's the way it is. This is the last round, last chance, 1-1 the tie. You need one to win. That's all. Could we make it any easier?
You got it.
How about match blank?
That's right. That's right. The name of the show is okay. Match Blank. What is a TV show yet?
Okay. Right.
Well, who's buried in Grant's tomb? Right, I know.
That's a trick one.
Harry said,
Harry?
I went to a wedding where the bride was so ugly, the groom... Rather timid, aren't you?
I have
one more chance for you. Harry said, I went to a wedding where the bride was so ugly... A little rehearsal doesn't hurt, does it?
No, it doesn't. Wouldn't hurt us.
Right. The groom didn't say, I do. He said, I blank. Went to a wedding where the bride was so ugly, the groom didn't say, I do. He said, I blank. There you go.
You mean I got one you like?
Yeah, I do, indeed. Ready, Sherry?
I'm ready.
You have one already. Good. Well, they're ready here, so let's go.
All right.
Went to a wedding where the bride was so ugly, the groom didn't say, I do. He said, I...
I don't.
I don't.
She's about as close to match blank as we could get.
Right. Barbara?
Is this the same, I won't?
I won't? No.
No.
No!
No, it's the same idea, but we got to be a little more exact.
Well, I said, I will not.
I will not. Okay.
Pretty
Ken?
These people are all going to find out where my mind runs. I have to.
I have to.
Pretty good.
It was a wedding in which the bride wore white, and the man who gave the bride away carried a white shotgun. Anyway, we're getting close to the dumb-off, aren't we? Okay, Richard.
Well, you're going to hate it, but I said I don't.
All right. That wins the game. What do you have, Gallagher?
Oh, I have to do.
I do do. Come on down. Yay. I'll be with you in a moment. Mark, it was a pleasure to meet you. We'll send some gifts your way from the match game. Mark King, ladies and gentlemen. There he goes. Well, congratulations to you. Time now to switch to Hollywood Squares. We're going to bring on three more celebrities. The rest of the set just came in. John Bauman and I will switch places here. We've got lots more excitement here. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Hitachi's Cassette Match Music System. FM, AM, stereo receiver with 7.5 watts per channel. Belt drive turntable with magnetic cartridge. Two-way high drone cone speaker system furnished by Hitachi. It's time for more of the match game. Hollywood Square. Our win. More of our tribute to Leave It to Beaver. With Frank Tank as Lundy.
I've asked you.
And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
Love us.
That's for us. Thank you. Welcome to the second half of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. And here I have with me Sherry Tash, rhymes with cash. and that stands for what she'd like to win here on Hollywood Squares. We also have three brand new celebrities. They are Rich Carell.
Hi.
Cleverly known as Richard on Leave It to Beaver. Frank Bank, known as Lumpy. And we have Jerry Weil, who is Judy Hensler, right?
That's right. They just called me Creepy Judy, that Creepy Judy.
Creepy Judy.
Yes.
I see. Frank Bank?
Yeah.
I see that being with Gallagher on this show all week has rubbed off on Frank's costuming.
No. John, this is the last show of the year, so I thought I'd add a little class to the show. Plus, I have an early New Year's Eve party in Pacoima, so we're leaving right after the show.
You know, you're one of the few people that we haven't asked what you now do for a living.
Yeah. I'm in the municipal bond business, in the securities business.
Oh, terrific. Okay, well, that stands for cash,
exciting,
too, so let's get underway. Here we go. Let's play Hollywood Squares. And before we get right into the game, we have to reacquaint ourselves with our defending champion. It is her second day. Her name is Andrea McInnes. She is returning with 1,725 smackaroos. That was not such a bad day's work.
No, not at all.
Why don't you just remind us a little bit about, you know, your life today, 25 words or less.
Okay, I'm originally from Alabama, and I moved to Southern California to pursue my career as a freelance artist. So I'm here.
Okay, well, now you'd like to pursue some more money on Hollywood Squares, I suppose. Let's play the game. We're going to play this game till you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever is ahead at that point, of course, is our winner. Goes on to play Supermatch for up to $30,000. First game is worth $100, $25 for every square that either of you might capture. Our champion always has the privilege of starting. That, of course, is you, Andrea. Pick a star and let's go.
Okay, Gallagher.
No. Why don't you take the Beaver?
Why don't you just answer this question, Gallagher?
Okay, what is it?
You're a hairy dog.
Ah!
Good thing that one went to
And
Gallagher.
You're about to give birth. According to Dog World magazine, should you get shaved?
Now, wait a minute. Who reads Dog World magazine? I'm a dog who reads the magazine. Okay.
According to Dog World magazine, now, should you get shaved or will just a trim do?
I think for an important thing like a birth, you should be shaved.
Agree or disagree, Andrew? You should get shaved to give birth.
Disagree.
A trim will do. You are perfectly right to disagree. You get the first square. Just a trim will do your dog. A little dog will do you. Okay. Sherry Tash, your move. Pick a star.
All right. I'll go with the Beaver.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, Beav. Who gets paid more money every month? A new enlistee in the U.S. Army? Or a person drawing maximum unemployment benefits in California?
Well, actors should know all about that, unemployment. The Army's gone up quite a bit in the last few years, and I'd have to say the Army.
Agree or disagree?
I will agree.
Sherry. Yeah, it is a person drawing maximum unemployment benefits in California who makes more money.
All right.
You should have disagreed. Your opponent gets that square. Okay, there's a bit of a break for you, Andrea McInnes. You have two X's up on the board already. Pick the place you'd like to put your next one.
With Richard on the top.
To win.
To win.
This will win you the first game. Rich, it's dinner time, and you're a moose.
A moose?
Which of these things are you more apt to eat? A tiny tree or a tiny beaver?
Piece of cake.
Can you believe that, Beav?
That's a piece of cake. You know the answer to that one. I know.
Here, none of that.
Really, I'm not sure if a moose is a meat eater, actually. So I think I see them always chewing on trees. I'll have to go with a tree, tiny tree.
He says that moose is more apt to eat a tiny tree. For the game, Andrea, do you agree or disagree?
Agree.
A tiny tree it is. You were right to agree. You get the square. You win the game. A clean sweep. In the first game, three X's in a row, and $175 for you. But there's still plenty of time. We're going to be right back to play a $200 game after these messages. You be sure to come back, too.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour.
On your screen.
Now back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Next game will be worth $200 plus $25 for every square you capture. Last game was won by Andrea. That means that Sherry gets to start this one. Pick a star.
All right. I'll start with Beaver.
Okay.
A little better this
good
time.
Place to go. Jerry Mathers. You've had a big fight with your boss. You're very angry. To get rid of your anger, Jerry, should you punch yourself in the stomach? Or fantasize that your boss's pants are falling down?
Well, let's see now. I think probably, if you know, punching yourself in the stomach wouldn't really do much for yourself. You might take out a little of your anger. I think if you fantasize that his pants were falling down, it'd relieve a lot of your tension, make him look foolish in your mind. So I'd have to go with that.
Agree or disagree, Sherry?
I will agree.
You should fantasize that his pants are falling down. You're right to agree, and you get the first square in this game. $25 as well. That gets you on the board. Okay, Andrea, pick a star.
Okay, Richard.
Rich Carell.
Yes, ma'am.
Which runs faster, Rich? An elephant or the water out of your average faucet?
An elephant or the water out of your average faucet?
Be careful.
Yeah, I got to be careful with that one. Okay. I would say that, well, you know, actually, people don't know, but elephants are fast. Really fast, when they're mad especially. I'll have to go with an elephant. I think an elephant goes faster.
He says an elephant runs faster than the water out of your faucet. Andrea, agree or disagree?
Disagree.
An elephant it is. You should have agreed with Rich. Your opponent gets that square. Okay, an elephant runs 18 miles an hour. Pretty fast. A faucet runs less than 1 mile per hour. That is a break for you, Sherry. You are playing O. Pick the place where you'd like to put your next one.
I'm going to go with Gallagher to win.
All right. Okay. A courageous woman. Gallagher.
Fantasize their pants are falling down.
In French, right? Yeah. Who's older, Gallagher? The Planters peanut symbol, Mr. Peanut.
Okay.
Or Jimmy Carter?
You remember the Planters peanut symbol is very old. I've seen it in some old things, and he's still around.
For the game, Sherry Tash, agree or disagree that the Planters peanut symbol is older than Jimmy Carter?
I agree.
Mr. Peanut it is. You are right to agree. You get the square. You win the game. And you forge into the lead. I might add, it's only by about 8 years. The Mr. Peanut's only 8 years older than Jimmy Carter.
Oh, well,
275 for you, Sherry. 175 for you, Andrea. But there's still plenty of time. We're going to clear the board and move right on to the next game. This one is worth $300. And the last one was won by Sherry. That means Andrea gets to start. Pick a star.
Okay, let's go with June.
June Cleaver, a.k.a. Barbara Billingsley. You've just bought a can of cling peaches in heavy syrup. According to government standards, how many of the peaches are allowed to have worms in them? None or 3%?
Well, I don't think we have 3%. I think we have to say none.
I agree.
3% is the correct answer. You should have disagreed with Mrs. Cleaver, and your opponent gets the first square. They're allowed to have 3% in a can of cling. Well, I'm a little worried about cling peaches, Mrs. Cleaver. Okay.
Let's get another government.
I'm a little worried about this. Sherry, your turn. Pick a star.
Richard.
Hello?
When you pass away, you want to be buried next to your dead dog. Does Dear Abby say this is okay? Or do you need counseling?
Well, I mean, you know how a lot of people get attached to animals. I don't think anybody who wants to be buried by their dog needs counseling. I say that she says, no, it's normal, it's okay.
It's okay to be buried next to your dead dog. Agree or disagree, Sherry?
I'll agree.
It's okay to be buried next to your dead dog. You are right to agree, and you got two O's up there. Andrea McInnes is our defending champ in a bit of trouble. She's got two O's. You are playing X. Pick a star.
Okay, Jean to block.
You missed this one. Another game is won by Sherry. Jean Rayburn.
Yep.
Before visiting an art exhibit on her trip to the Orient, First Lady Nancy Reagan told reporters that they had to wear something. Was it red, white, and blue clothes or clean socks without holes?
I'm surprised you asked that question. Because it was such a well-publicized story,
You know, she being the first lady, it made headlines. I read it in the New York Times. She said, everyone must wear clean socks with no holes. No signs of having been darned either.
Agree or disagree, Andrea, to block.
Can you repeat that one more time?
Yes, it was an art exhibit, a trip to an art exhibit in the Orient, and Nancy Reagan told reporters they had to wear something. Choices were red, white, and blue clothes, and Jean says, no, it wasn't that. It was clean socks without holes.
I agree with Jean.
Clean socks without holes it is. You're right to agree, you get the square, and you do block. Because they had to take their shoes off, naturally, it was in the Orient, and she didn't want them to be embarrassed. Okay, we're going to be back to complete what has become a pretty close and pretty exciting game right after these messages.
All of the shop.
You know, before we get right back into the game, in this last commercial break, this is truly a mother to the end. June Cleaver, Barbara Billingsley, Beaver's mother, called me over and she said, John, did you really think that you can have 3% worms in those peaches? And yes, we have researched that, and it is absolutely true. That's true, Mom. I mean it, I mean it, I mean it.
You don't need
okay.
that much.
Sherry, it's your move. Pick a star where you'd like to put an O.
Okay, Beaver, let's go again.
Okay, here we go.
The beeve. Which takes longer? A beaver making love or boiling an egg until it's hard?
Well, yeah. I thought it was a beaver till it was hard. But, no. I would say probably a beaver. A beaver making love would take longer than the egg.
Agree or disagree, Sherry?
I'll disagree.
Boiling an egg until it's hard takes longer. You were right to disagree. This might shock you, Beeve. This might shock you.
I'm
a beaver takes about a minute.
Uh-oh.
Jerry, can you substantiate
okay,
that?
Okay, Andrea.
Quick as a beaver.
You are playing X. Pick a star for me.
Okay, Eddie, let's go to block.
Eddie Haskell or Ken Osmond. You're wearing a suit made entirely of Kevlar. While you have it on, it will help prevent something. Will it prevent you from sweating or from being shot?
You're talking to the right man, because I happen to know exactly what Kevlar is. It's bulletproofing. That's what police vests are made out of.
So he says it will prevent you from being shot. This is to block. So if you miss this one, Sherry will take another game. Agree or disagree, Andrea?
I'm going to have to agree with the policeman.
It'll prevent you from being shot. The policeman got the right question. You're right to agree, and you do block. Okay, it's really getting interesting now. Sherry, pick a star.
Gallagher to win, please.
Mm-hmm. All right. Here's the pressure.
Can still do it for you. She blocked you one place, but not here. Gallagher, which came first? The caveman or the cockroach?
Well, this is an interesting question, because if you don't have any cavemen, then you don't have any corners for the cockroaches to hide in. I'm going to say the cockroach, a very ancient animal, older than the dinosaurs.
For the game, at a pretty big lead, agree or disagree, the cockroach came before the caveman, Sherry.
I will agree.
The cockroach came before the caveman. You're right to agree. You win the game. Three in a row diagonally. Well done, and a pretty sizable lead. 675, but 225 for Andrea. You're still in it, because we're going to clear the board and move right on to the next game, worth $400. Andrea, you get to start this one. Pick a star.
Okay, let's go in the middle with Beaver.
Okay.
Okay, Beaver. According to a 17 magazine poll, do the majority of teenage girls today approve or disapprove of sex before marriage?
I would think that they would disapprove it from 17 magazine.
Says they disapprove of sex before marriage. Majority of teenage girls, Andrea.
Agree.
They approve of sex before marriage. You should have disagreed with that beaver, and your opponent gets the square. Okay, Sherry, you're off to a good start. Pick a star where you'd like to put an O.
Judy, please.
Jerry Weil.
Yes.
Your married lover just died. According to Ann Landers, should you stay away from the funeral, or is it okay to attend as long as you're quiet?
As long as I don't say anything. I don't think you should go. I would stay away from the funeral.
Okay, she says,
Yes, it's according to Ann Landers. Now, it's your married lover who's just died. The question is, should you stay away from the funeral, or is it okay to attend as long as you're quiet? She said you should stay away.
I'll disagree.
You can attend as long as you're quiet. You are very smart to disagree, and you get the square. That is good playing. But she sounded like she knew, I believe her. Okay, Andrea, now you could be really on the ropes. Pick a star for your ex.
Okay, we've got to go with Gene to block.
You sure do. Gene.
Yes?
In Africa, what animal kills more human beings than any other? Is it the lion, the crocodile, or the mosquito?
Man, the animal kills more animals than any other.
Truth.
Yes. Unfortunately, no.
Not one of the choices.
Yeah. It's the mosquito?
Yes, the lion and the crocodile.
Mosquito, lions, and crocodiles. Well, it's incongruous, I know, but it must be the mosquito.
Yes. Agree or disagree that it's the mosquito that kills more human beings than these others?
I would have to agree. I mean, it sounds crazy, but I agree.
It sounds a little too crazy because it's the crocodile. You should have disagreed. Your opponent gets the square and wins another game. Rio's up there, and that bell means the time is up with $1,150. Our new champion, Sherry Tan. Congratulations, Sherry. You've done good. Go right over there with your escort, Gene Rayburn. He's going to get you ready for your shot at the big money. Don't let him get you too ready, though, okay? Andrea. We have to say goodbye to you, but you have a pretty nice New Year's present to start off 1984, $1,950. Not too bad. And, of course, you have our thanks for playing Match Game Hollywood Squares. And you're lovely.
Thank you very much.
And speaking of lovely people, here is Gene Rayburn.
All right. Thank you, John. Here we are with Sherry. Our congratulations to her. She'll be back in a moment or so, and so will our nine celebrities. She's going to try for the really big, big money right after this.
Answer?
To order yours right now.
Now, here to play the Super Match is Gene Rayburn.
All right, Sherry's very excited. This is her first time up here, and she's going to have a go at the big money. How do you feel?
Terrific.
Good. Great. It's a super match where she can win up to $30,000. Let's have a go at it, Sherry. We polled a recent studio audience, and we said, please write down your best answer to this. Blank Moore. The top answer is worth $1,000. Next one, $500. Bottom one, $250. Now, any three of our nine stars can offer suggestions here to fill in that blank to give you a little assistance. Whom do you want to call on?
Lumpy.
Mary Tyler Moore.
Mary Tyler Moore is one.
Mr. Rutherford.
Gary Moore.
Gary Moore is two.
John.
Dudley Moore.
Dudley Moore. So you have Dudley, Mary Tyler, and Gary. You may choose one of those, or if you think you've got a better idea, that would be up on that board, then you'll give us that one. What is your pleasure?
Mary Tyler Moore.
Mary Tyler Moore. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $250 response. Gary Moore is there, a wonderful fellow. All right, the next one says, Mary Tyler Moore. That's your answer. What do you think's on top?
Dudley.
You think Dudley's on top? Do you think Dudley's on top, audience?
Yeah!
You're not sure, are you? All right, let's all find out together. Go. Roger Moore. You weren't sure.
Roger?
007.
007, Richard.
Bond.
Yes,
Bond.
Roger Moore. All right, now you've got $500, Sherry, and you're going to play the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And as you can see, each star has a number, a 10, a 20, a 30. It's a hidden number. And we will multiply that $500, which is yours, by whatever number is revealed when you choose a star. Are you ready to do that?
Yes.
Which one do you want?
John.
All right. John Bauman, she's chosen you. Would you grab the tab, please, and reveal your hidden number? A 20. Good. That means you're playing for $10,000. All right, Sherry.
So Dudley's going to be heartbroken.
10,000. Here we go, John. Friday, blank. Friday, blank. All right, John is ready. Sherry, it's up to you. The money is yours if you match John Bauman. Friday, blank.
My mind's a blank. Oh, Friday. I can't think. Thank goodness it's Friday, but that would... Friday night.
Friday night. All right. John, she said Friday night. What do you say to that?
You know, it's funny because this is... It's supposed to be unlucky, and in this case it was. Friday the 13th.
Friday the 13th. Good response. Well, Sherry, you haven't done too badly. You've got a total of $1,650. That's yours forever, and you're still the champ. You'll play tomorrow. Come back right after these messages. All right, let's find out now. Which of the stars had the big 3-0? Would you all grab the tabs and give it a pull? June. All right, here we go.
Voulez-vous.
Judy had it up
in the corner.
The big 3-0.
Gallagher had the definitive answer, he said, to Friday blank.
Well, I have the 12th. Is that
Friday the 12th.
Friday the 12th. Yeah. Very good, Gallagher. Hey, listen, Gallagher, you were okay.
Well, it's New Year.
It's New Year's.
Happy New Year.
Thank you all.
Thank you all for coming. Leave it to Beaver. Let's hear it.
So long, Dean. So long, Rich. Thank you for bringing back some wonderful memories.
Mr. Rutherford wants some of your hair. All of it. Gallagher can use some, too.
Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year to you.
And
it's been a pleasure.
You. You started it off correctly.
And many, many more on this show.
Thank you. Happy New Year, all. Gene Rayburn here inviting you to join us next time.
And John Bowen saying goodbye for Match Game Hollywood Squares. See you next year.
Audience will receive a 19-inch color TV, keyboard control, electronic tube, 3 automatic color systems, and automatic light sensor, furnished by Montgomery Ward. And... This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.